Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'll be discussing with you a character who doesn't get as much love as he should, and that character is Michael Holt, aka Mr. Terrific. But first, if you're new to this channel, hit the like button, hit that subscribe button, and post a comment below. Let me know what you think about the character of Mr. Terrific. So, Mr. Terrific's first appearance is Spectre Volume 3, Issue 54. He was created by John Estrader and Tom Mandrake. Mr. Terrific has a tragic past. What superhero origin would be without a tragic past? You see, he was arguing with his wife, who was pregnant at the time, about religion being pointless. She gets into a fatal car crash, which devastates him because the last thing they said to each other wasn't "I love you." He contemplated suicide, blaming himself for her death. He was met with the arrival of the Spectre. The Spectre tells him about Terry Sloan, the original Mr. Terrific, on how he fought for truth and justice. Seeing the similarities between them, he decided to take the mantle of Mr. Terrific. Now, Michael is a normal human with no special abilities, but if you ask what his skill set is, he would tell you that he has an aptitude for a natural aptitude because he can pick up on complex skills and abilities that others spend their entire lives perfecting, like when he performed surgery on Alan Scott after reading a medical textbook about the procedure. He's just that good. As Holt himself put it, everyone has a talent in something. His is learning, but the best ability he has is the T-shaped spears. The T-shaped spears are floating robotic spears you see floating around him. They have holographic projection, projecting laser grids, reading, manipulating other electronic devices. They also give Mr. Terrific the ability to fly, bearing his weight on them. But the best thing about them is that they can be used for combat purposes, as they have enough force to knock Shazam back. They also have a powerful electrical shock and can be used as projectile weapons. They respond to his mental and vocal commands. Mr. Terrific is invisible to all forms of electronic detection. This is because of the T-mask that is on his face, which has nanotechnology woven into his mask, which is molecularly bonded to his face, so it can appear and disappear at will. It also allows him to communicate with his T-spears. His invisibility is so great that the supercomputer OMAC couldn't even detect him. And the only exception to this rule is Red Tornado, who is technically an android, but because he's like an elemental type android is why he can see Mr. Terrific. The fair play on his sleeve is a homage to the original Mr. Terrific. It is a message to not take the easy way out and always fight fair. He especially wanted the youngsters to see that on his sleeves. He is described as the third smartest man in the DC universe. He holds over 14 PhDs, which is 2 in engineering and physics, a doctor's and master's degree in law, psychology, chemistry, political science. This makes him a polymath. He's also one of the 3 superheroes who have medical training, with the other 2 being Dr. Midnight and Batman. Considered to be in the top 10 fighter, one of the top 10 fighters in the DC universe, he holds black belts in 6 different martial arts, as well as a gold medal decathlon winner. What is interesting is that Mr. Terrific has a friendly rivalry with Batman, because both men are regarded as the smartest men in the DC universe. But the one thing that Batman has over Mr. Terrific is that Wayne Corporation's own cyberware. Speaking of cyberware is Holt business. You see, Michael is a self-made millionaire. Another interesting thing about Holt is that he is an atheist, even though he has seen the Spectre. And as he will put it, the only thing he believes in is his teammates. What I want you guys to get out of this is to show how good of a character Mr. Terrific really is. And the good thing about the characters that he actually has his own comic book, and he has appeared in other sorts of media, especially like the Justice League Unlimited in 2006. He appeared in that. He appeared in the Fatal 5. I actually just watched that again. Really, really good TV show, movie. I mean, you should watch it. But to be honest, the only thing about his appearance that I really wasn't feeling too much was the Arrowverse version Him because the Arrowverse version of him, I really didn't like it because truthfully, he was a subordinate of of Green Arrow, and Green Arrow in the Arrowverse is an analog to Batman more than Green Arrow of the comic book. So to me, he should have been more of a rival to Green Arrow than a subordinate, and he can't really fight in the Arrowverse. So I wasn't really feeling that too much. But other than that, I would say that this is a really, really, really good character. I do hope that the Terrifics get like a TV show out. But I am going to end this video. I do hope you guys enjoyed the video. And I will talk to you guys on the next video. Peace out, y'all.